It's a girl.
Every day we dance and life's been smiling. I'm delighted 'cause I got you.
Everyone, my name is Natalie. Welcome to my channel if it's the first time you've ever been here. I make lifestyle and mommy videos on this channel and I post a couple times a week. If you can't already tell, I am super excited about the fact that this week I found out that I am having a little girl. And if you guys want to see the super emotional, exciting gender reveal, we did a Christmas themed gender reveal, hence the brightly pink colored Christmas tree in the background of this video. I'm gonna have that video linked in our description box. It's over on my vlog channel. My mom was the only one who knew the results of the ultrasound and she set up the gender reveal for us. And so we found out live on the camera. It was our raw reaction and Weston and I could not be happier. I had my anatomy scan gender ultrasound on the day I turned 20 weeks pregnant. Normally I film my videos on that day, but because the day was so busy, the only thing I was able to film was my belly shot for you all. I really try to have my belly shot, if nothing else, be on the day my weeks turn over so that we have an accurate comparison from week to week. But it has been a few days. I think I am 20 weeks and 3 or 4 days pregnant right now because I wanted to wait those couple of days to, first of all, have my ultrasound, second of all, have the gender reveal happen, and then to be able to digest the information a little bit and to share with you what I'm feeling. Just like I do in every pregnancy update, I am going to tell you my stats and symptoms and how the baby is developing, and I'm gonna go over those things before I tell you my full thoughts and feelings about finding out that I'm having a girl, as well as tell you how that ultrasound, the anatomy scan, 20 week anatomy scan went. So this week at 20 weeks when I stepped on the scale, I was 120 and a half pounds, which is about a half a pound of weight gain from last week. I am 32 inches around, so I gained another inch around my tummy. It just keeps growing. Little one in there is growing and developing. I didn't really have any new symptoms this week. In fact, I would say that the symptoms I experienced in the previous weeks have actually gone down a notch, but I think I've also been really distracted with just thinking about this whole gender reveal and finding out what our baby is and all of that. So I haven't paid as close of attention. There's just nothing much to report as far as new symptoms go. Definitely nothing new. Baby this week is the length of a banana. Now my app is talking about length when they are comparing the baby's size to a fruit or vegetable. Before, it was more about the weight of the baby and sort of the overall size. But in week 20, things change a little bit and they no longer measure the baby from crown to rump, but it's now from crown to heel. So that's what makes it the length of a banana this week. So that's pretty fun. And speaking of bananas, I have upped my intake of potassium by eating bananas, and I got some great suggestions from you all in last week's video about what other foods that are high in potassium, because a few weeks ago I was actually experiencing some leg cramps and it was suggested that I needed more potassium, so that has been helping. Not too many leg cramps to speak of in this last week, and I think it's thanks to the potassium rich foods that I've been eating, including bananas. So at 20 weeks, baby is 10 ounces approximately and 6.5 inches long. At my ultrasound, the baby was measuring right at where it should be, and it was approximately 11.5 ounces heavy is what the tech told me. So because it has been a couple of days since my ultrasound and I haven't heard anything, they told me that if I didn't hear anything within 48 hours of getting my ultrasound, that there was no immediate issue with the baby, that there was nothing that needed further testing, and that I would just discuss little things with my doctor at my next appointment. So making it past that 48 hour mark without getting a phone call felt really good. No news is good news after you've had a big ultrasound like that. Here's a little 3D version of the baby here in the Bump app. I love being able to flip through all the different little points of interest on this app with the little 3D feature telling me the different parts of development in the baby. The baby right now is swimming around. She is kicking like crazy. Oh my gosh, it is so weird to say she. Now that I'm talking about the baby, last time I was pregnant, they were both boys, twins pregnancy with fraternal boys. And so I said he or they a lot. And like I said before, I didn't find out what I was having during the ultrasound. The nurse gave that information to my mom at the end of the ultrasound. So laying there, I kept saying they in the plural form because it's just such a force of habit. It's what I'm used to. But now I am going around saying she or her or little girl and talking to the boys about having a little sister. And it is so different for me. It is such a different experience. And I am someone who really craves change. And so being able to experience something that is different from my last experience is just so fulfilling to me. And she's not even here yet. Like, I don't even know the full scope of this change because she's not actually here, but just the idea and going through girls' names and, you know, nursery ideas and all of that. It's just so fun to be able to experience it on the other side of things by expecting a little girl. So I shared in my gender reveal vlog that I really hadn't been thinking about what this baby is because I didn't want to get my hopes up either way. And actually, I think it was because I didn't want to get my hopes up for a girl. I know what it's like to have a boy and I love it. I love being a mom to boys. It is such an amazing experience. I love my little boys so much. So I knew that if I found out that I was having another little boy, that I would not be disappointed. I would be so thrilled that I get to draw on the experience from before and raise another little boy. And I just think having three boys and being a boy mom would just be such a fantastic, amazing, fulfilling experience. But then on the flip side of that, I also knew that, you know, just a deep desire of mine was to have a daughter. Little history on Natalie. I grew up as the oldest of four girls in my family until I was almost a teenager. And then my mom and dad had a little boy, my little brother Luke, whom I love. He was my little baby brother and my sweetheart. And I had such a special bond with Luke. But I spent the majority of my childhood, because by the time I was almost a teenager, I was, you know, past a lot of my childhood sort of behavior and age and all of that. So I spent the majority of my childhood as the oldest of an only girl sort of family. So I knew forever that I definitely wanted to live out my experience within my own family by having a daughter of my own. My mom and I have an incredible relationship. She's one of my very best friends. And so I'm really looking forward to fostering that sort of relationship with my own daughter. My siblings and I were homeschooled, and so I spent a lot of time with my mom in the homeschooling thing, doing home ec, and of course things that you could teach to a boy, things that I certainly will teach to my sons, and things that my mom has taught to my little brother. But there's something special about the bond between a mother and a daughter, especially on a very feminine level, that I feel so blessed that I get to anticipate that experience. And I know I have so many years ahead of me of being a mom, and I just think it's so cool. I just feel like having a girl is going to round out our family in such an incredible way. It's gonna be like that little thing that just enhances and completes us. Yes, I would have been thrilled if I found out that it was a boy, because as a Christian, I of course trust that God has it all put together and that his plan for our family, he's the only one who has control over, you know, gender and that sort of a thing. And so I would have accepted it and I would have been thrilled and not disappointed. But now that I know that I get a girl and I get to truly let myself experience the anticipation and the planning process of welcoming a daughter into my life, I can't imagine it any other way. I am so excited. So I have gotten super rambly and I hope you guys don't mind. These are just like my unfiltered, raw thoughts in light of this gender reveal. I am so very thrilled. I feel absolutely blessed. Thank you guys for being patient with me while I have this heart to heart with you. I feel like I just totally word vomited, but in the best way possible, right? Because I hope you can feel my joy here. Like, I don't know if it's translating over here into the camera, but I am so incredibly joyful in this situation. I can't stop smiling. I've got this glow, which for some reason in my old wives' tales, gender predictions, I went through everything and I was like 50-50, five for a boy, five for a girl. So it could have gone either way. And I'll actually have that video linked in our description box. Weston and I sat down and went through a list of 10 old wives' tales predictions, which, you know, some of them are kind of based in science loosely and other are more like voodoo, but it was really fun to be able to do that. So it's a fun video. Go check it out and check out our gender reveal on our vlog channel. Subscribe over there if you're interested in seeing more of like the day-to-day life that I have. This is more of my sit-down video, my own little space, and I do lifestyle and mommy stuff and I have a lot of fun. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you clicked on this video because you are 20 weeks pregnant and you want to see what the experience of someone else is like, would you please just let me know in the comments what your symptoms this week have been, what you've been experiencing at your halfway mark in pregnancy. It's a huge milestone and I'm so proud of my body and so proud of my little girl that we've made it this far already, and I am looking forward to the second half of this pregnancy having the knowledge that I'm having a little girl. I think it's pretty cool that I get to spend the second half of my pregnancy knowing what I'm having. That's pretty neat. So I'm gonna stop rambling. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it and subscribe to my channel and turn those channel notifications on if you want to be up to date with my pregnancy from here on out. Thank you so much for watching today's video and I'll catch you later.
Oh, I got you. There's no reason to